Okay, we have a Magnavox integrated compact stereo system, and I'm assuming it's from the early 1980s, but I'm gonna go ahead and test it out for you guys. So, just real quickly, there's the power button, there's the functions, phono, tape, FM stereo, FM AM, you got your headphone jack, your left and right microphone inputs, you have the, let me zoom out some, then you have the first tape deck, then you have the second tape deck for high speed dubbing, which is right there. Power indicator. And if I turn this up, alright, so then you have your AM FM tuner, and then of course the record player on top. So that sounds pretty good. Now this is going through my speakers, those right there, but the normal speakers that this thing came with is right here. Not very big. They sound okay, but not great. So let's try the, see if the 45s work. All right, we'll try Princeton Revolution. Let's see if the tape deck works. We'll play Pink Floyd The Wall. On tape. Wow. That sounds better than I thought it would. Let's try the other side. Let's flip it over on this side, see what it sounds like. Side two. Wow, both sides work really good. You know, and all I did was just took a Q-tip and cleaned the heads a little bit with some alcohol. So apparently that really, really did the trick. Let's listen to the FM stereo. It's actually picking up pretty good. All right, so that's it. The Magnavox integrated compact stereo system. I'm guessing it's probably from like the early 80s. I mean, that's what it looks like. But, no. Even though it was considered a not very well built system back in the day, it's still better than the crap they're putting out today. Like those Ion record players and things like that just seem to break and the stylus, the needle on it, they just sound horrible when you play a record on them. But this one actually did a really good job. So I just want to make a quick video about this. I will be selling this. I mean, I've already got a couple record players, so I don't need this one. So if you're interested, just hit me back. I'll probably be asking around $50 for it. But like I said, if you want to get into collecting some vintage vinyl records or some, you know, cassette tapes, you want to revisit some old cassette tapes, or if you need a device that can actually burn or play something to a computer so you can capture the audio, this right here would work. You would just take your speaker outputs and plug it right into the back of your line in on your computer, and you could actually capture the audio and turn them into MP3 files. But I mean, if you want to be old school, just listen to it the way it was intended to be listened to. You know, take a record out, put it on the disc, put it on the player, play it, listen to it. Same with the tapes, you know. Other than that, thanks for watching.